it going, everyone? This is Christian Nault alongside Neil Damani. Here we are at Avondale versus Berkeley, first home swim meet for Avondale. The 200-yard medley relay is just about to start here.
This is heat one of one. In lane one, we have Avondale. Lane two is Berkeley. Lane three is Avondale. Lane four is Berkeley, and lane five is Avondale.
For those of you who don't know, the medley relay consists of four different strokes all swam by different swimmers. So the first will start off with the backstroke, as you see here. Then the next swimmer would jump in and do the breaststroke.
And after the breaststroke, we have butterfly. And to top it off, we have freestyle to end it.
So it looks like Berkeley's in the lead, but Avondale's slowly coming up. Alrighty. Looks like Avondale and Berkeley are neck and neck right now going into the butterfly.
And it looks like Berkeley's starting to pull away here.
Berkeley a good two, three, four, maybe four body lengths on Avondale right now. Going in, Stone Rogers will be the anchor here for Avondale. And Joseph Leverett should be finishing here pretty soon for Berkeley Bears. First place finish for Berkeley. And there it is, Berkeley first place. Nice swim.
And Avondale is just finishing up right now.
That's a good sportsmanship there. Gotta love to see that. All right, it looks like Avondale captures third place, Berkeley with fourth place. Finishes up the 200 medley relay in fifth place. Alrighty. Good swim by the boys. Good way to start this meet off.
Up next is the 200 freestyle the 200 yard freestyle. There's only one heat. Lanes 1, 3, and 5 are Avondale, and lanes 2, 4, and 6 are Berkeley.
So lane 1 here, we got Richard Fawaz from Avondale. Lane 2, Stuart Craig from Berkeley. Lane 3, Kendall Cunnings from Avondale. Lane 4, Caleb Duchon from Berkeley. Lane 5, Colin Foltz from Avondale. And lane 6, Alex Blank from Berkeley. So going into the first lap, we got, looks like Avondale's in, or Berkeley's in first. So the 200 yard freestyle is an individual event where the swimmer will do a total of 8 lengths of the pool or 4 laps.
It looks like lane 5 for Avondale is catching up to Berkeley in lane 4.
That's Colin Foltz in lane 5 there.
Here they are, neck to neck.
Seems to be a race right now of Colin Fulton, Caleb Bruchana. Caleb with the slight lead over Colin. Looks like Caleb Duchon, the good body length on Colin Fultz.
Starting to pull away here.
And there it is. Your first place finisher is Caleb Duchon, followed by Colin Fultz. Third place is neck and neck. Looks like Kendall Cunnings with the third place finish, followed by Stuart Craig. Here finishing fifth, it looks like Alex.
Alex Blank for Berkeley takes fifth, and we are just waiting on Richard Fawaz, who's about to finish right here.
Alrighty. Good swim by the boys. Next up, we have the 200-yard individual medley. This is heat one of one. Looks like we're about to start the 200 IM soon.
Just waiting here on the timers, I believe.
They go on the 200 IM.
This is event three, the 200 IM. In lane one, we have Darren Joback from Avondale. Lane two, we have Jonathan Scher from Berkeley. Lane three, we have Daniel Wang from Avondale. Lane four is Evan Carpenter from Berkeley. Lane five is Charlie Connell from Avondale. And lane six is Colton Tyker from Berkeley.
Like Berkeley off to the quick lead. Looks like Berkeley in first and second, Avondale third and fourth. The 200 IM is again eight lengths, but this time the swimmers cycle through the four strokes, starting off with butterfly, followed by backstroke and breaststroke, and finishing off with the freestyle. See the turn there going into breaststroke, about halfway done now. Berkeley again with the lead, that's Evan Carpenter, freshman.
His teammate is also right behind him in second place, and then Avondale is slightly behind.
Looks like Berkeley here is going to finish first. That's Evan Carpenter. Pretty sizable lead right now against the Yellow Jackets.
Looks like Jonathan Scher from Berkeley is also going to finish second place. And with Avondale coming in third and fourth. Actually, there's someone
like,
in lane six.
Yeah. Looks like Berkeley's going to sweep this one. One, two, three, all by Berkeley. It's a good swim by Berkeley. Charlie Conniff, Daniel Wang just finished, and got one more from Avenue. So Darren here is about to just finish his final length. His teammates are cheering them all on every step of their way.
Here he is, closing in on the last length.
So it looks like Berkeley's going to take the lead quickly in this meet here. They finished first in the last couple of events, so strong showing here by the Bears. All right, next up we have the 50 freestyle. This is heat one of three.
These first two heats are all exhibitions, so they don't actually count for points. And in this first heat, there is lanes 1, 2, 3, and 5 are all Avondale, and lane 4 is Berkeley.
It's rainy to start. So this is swimming's fastest event. This is two lengths, one lap pretty much. This is one of the more exciting ones. Look out for Noah Burton. He was a diver last year, but I guess proves himself as a pretty decent swimmer. There he is in lane one. Looks like Noah going into the turn takes the lead. Pretty easy win here for Noah.
Looks like Noah wins this heat.
Followed by John Boyden. Third place, lane four. That's Sam Hurwitz. Looks like finishing fourth is Abu. All right, here we go for heat two, 50 freestyle. Heat one, we have Joey Mascoro. Lane two, we have Tomoki Akada. Lane three, we have Cedric J. Rivera. Lane four, we have Brendan Smith. Lane five, Jerome Burton. And lane six, Sam Myers. Again, this is an exhibition heat, so it doesn't count for points. Looks like lane two, followed by lane four. Alrighty. So lane five. Lane five and two.
Looks like lane five, lane two, then lane four. Then lane three, six, and one.
Alrighty, good win by John there. Tomoki Akada, the first place finish. All right, this is our final heat for the 50 freestyle. Lane one, we have Justin Van Acker. Lane two, Matt Mancini. Lane three, I'm sorry, I'm going to butcher that last name.
Lane three is Emil. And And lane 4 is Eli. Lane 5 is Stone Rogers. And lane 6 is Benjamin Vincent.
Oh, that's a mill. That's a mill. Looks like lane 3 and 4 pretty close right now. It's going to be a close one.
And it looks like...
Oh, man, that was pretty close to...
Unfortunately, I think our timing, our timers are broken right now, so we're using hand clocks.
So Emil and Eli with a neck-and-neck finish there. I couldn't tell you from here. But I'm sure we'll get the results soon, see who this winner was.
We'll let you know. Diving's up next, so we'll get the results shortly.
Pull your face mask down. All right. What about the chest guard? It looks loose. Is it loose? All right, what about the shin guards? All right. Okay. Here comes the heat. Bring it in. Good hustle.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of teens in foster care who would love to put up with you.
Alrighty, here we are back at Avondale versus Berkeley swim meet. We're just about to start diving. The only diver today is Berkeley's Mason Allison, who's a freshman. So here he goes with his first dive. Nice dive there by Mason, awarded 4.5, 4.5, 4. Again, I am Christian Nault alongside Neil Damani. Each diver is given 6 dives. That was the first one.
And here we are, Mason's about to do a second dive shortly.
Another strong dive there by Mason. Again, he's only a freshman, so a lot of upside for that kid.
And it looks like he got 5.5 straight across the board. And saw the support from his teammates there earlier after that dive.
Berkeley is a rowdy bunch.
Berkeley will definitely benefit from being the only team with a diver automatically scoring the first place points allotted. So. Here goes Mason with his third dive of the night.
Mason's third dive of the night. Looks like six and a half. Another good dive by Mason. It's increasing his score every dive.
I think you see there his coach giving him some pointers for his next dive, tell him what to do better.
Another good dive there by Mason. Scores are 5, 5.5, 5.5. Fifth dive here by Mason. Pretty consistent scoring so far.
Looks like he got a 4.5, 5, and 4.5.
That was Mason's fifth dive. We only have one more here. So regardless, Berkeley will get the points for the first place finish for diving. Avondale is definitely going to have to pick it up in the second half here. So they're going to want to escape the first home meet with a win.
Believe this is Mason's last dive. That was his last dive, getting 4, 4, and 4.
Nice night of diving there for Mason. Gets a nice handshake from his coach. It's always nice to see. Berkeley's definitely riled up about it.
And we will have another 5-minute warm-up before we start the next event, which is the 100-yard butterfly.
Hi, I'm Tony Lockard. I'm taking this class to work with technology.
Hi, my name is Sandra, and I'm taking this course because I want to learn how to produce and edit film.
Hi, my name is Mike, and I'm taking this class to learn more about behind the scenes.
Hi, my name is Nicholas. I am a music producer and a DJ, and I wanted to learn how to make my own videos.
Hi, my name is Daryl. I'm trying to take the course to have my own cooking show.
Hi, I'm Trey, and I'm taking this course because I'd like to learn how to do television shows.
All right, I'm Joseph McAuliffe, 23 years old, and I'm taking this class on account of that I like movies so much so that I want to learn how to make them.
My name is Kevin, and my goal is to make the world's best crepe.
Hi, my name is Chris. I'm teaching this class, and today I'm wearing a blue shirt.
We are CMAN TV!
Alright, here we are back at the Avondale versus Berkeley swim meet. Avondale's first home meet. We're through diving. This current score is 44-24. Our upcoming event, we have the 100 butterfly. This is heat 1 of 1.
And with that score, Berkeley is ahead of Avondale 44-24.
Thank you. Didn't specify that. I'm Christian Nault alongside Neil Damani. So there they go, the 100-yard butterfly. In lane one, we have Keegan Outland for the Yellow Jackets. Lane two, Cameron Burt for the Berkeley Bears. Lane three, Andy Zhang for the Yellow Jackets. Lane four, Eli Folk for the Berkeley Bears. Kulan Damani's in lane five for the Yellow Jackets, and Benjamin Vincent in lane six for the Berkeley Bears. So it looks like going to the first lap here, we have Eli Folk, who's a junior in first place. Seeded it for a time of 1:02. Second place, it looks like Andy Zhang from Avondale. So it looks like Eli Folk will win this one pretty easy. Berkeley has pretty much dominated this swim meet so far. Wins by a good 4-5 seconds. Andy Zhang coming in second. So it looks like Berkeley with third. Evandale with 4th and 5th, and then Berkeley with 6th place here for the 100-yard butterfly. Again, the winner here is Eli Folk from Berkeley.
For event 7, the upcoming event, we have the boys 100-yard freestyle. This will be 3 heats, so the first 2 heats will be exhibition and will not count for points.
So, this upcoming event, we have in lane 2, Shahraz Khan. Lane 3, Abu. Lane 4, Sam Hurwitz. And lane 5, Joey Mascaro. Lane 2, 3, and 5 are all Avondale Yellow Jackets. And lane 4 is the only Berkeley Bear on this event. There they go. 100-yard freestyle is a freestyle event, obviously, where the swimmers 4 lengths in total and 2 laps. This is another one of the quicker events.
And it looks like Joey Mascaro is in the lead right now.
And lane 4, followed by lane 3, Sam Hurwitz for Berkeley. Nice turn there by Sam, gaining a little bit of room onto Joey there. All right, going into the final length, we have Joey Mascaro in first place, followed by Sam Hurwitz. In lane 3, I believe, we have Abu Bangura. And
looks like Joey won that heat with Sam taking second place.
So a no-show for lane 2. Shahraz Khan, MIA. So here we go in heat 2 here for the 100-yard freestyle. Coming up here in about a few seconds, as we finish for Abu to finish. All right, there you go for Abu. And heat 2, we have lane 2, Alex Blank. Heat 3, Jerron Burton. Lane 4, Sam Meyer. Lane 5, Noah Burton. And lane 6, Tomoki Okada.
Once again, this is another exhibition heat, so this will not count for points.
Alrighty, looks like Avondale off to the quick lead there.
Looks like Noah Burton is in the lead right now.
Noah Burton followed by Jerron Burton. So the Burton brothers are taking this event, it looks like, going into the second turn.
And it looks like lane 6 is catching up. That is Tomoki Okada.
Alrighty, going into the final length, we have Noah Burton, it looks like, holding on to first place, holding off Tomoki Oh, it was a close finish. It was hard to tell for that one.
Tomoki might have taken that one with that poor finish by Noah.
Yeah. So we're going to say Tomoki took it, the first place finish there from Berkeley. Going into the Heat 3 from Avondale, lane 1, we have Daniel Wang. Lane 2 from Berkeley, we have Joseph Leverett. Lane 3, we have Kendall Cunnings from the Yellow Jackets. Lane 4, Caleb Duchon from Berkeley Bears. Lane 5, Colin Fultz from the Yellow Jackets. And lane 6, Jonathan Scher from the Berkeley Bears. Looks like Caleb Duchon is heavily favored in this one. Seed time of 57.34 seconds. And looks like he is.
After the first turn, it looks like it's pretty close.
Right.
With
lane 2, lane 4, and lane 5 seem to be duking it out right now. Looks like lane 2 going into the first turn has the lead. That's Joseph Leverett. Followed by Caleb Duchon and Colin Fultz. So going into the final turn, it looks like lane 2, that's Joseph Leverett in first place, followed by Caleb Duchon, both for the Berkeley Bears, and lane 5, Colin Fultz from Avondale. It looks like Joseph took that one. So good job by Joseph Leverett from Berkeley, sophomore, finished first. Second place, Caleb Duchon from Berkeley, and Colin Fultz, third place from Avondale. Berkeley continues to dominate this meet.
This next event is the 500-yard freestyle. There's only one heat.
So this 500 freestyle is pretty gruesome one in terms of the swimmers. 20 lengths in total for the swimmers, the 500 yard is. And I remember in high school, I never wanted to swim the 500. I swam it maybe 5 times. I always snake tongue my way out of it, as I'm sure many swimmers have tried. So the brave souls line up.
At the end of each of the lanes, they got lap recorders so they know what lap they're on.
So here we are, 500-yard freestyle in lane 1. We have John Oden from the Yellow Jackets. Lane 2, we got Matt Mancini from Berkeley. Lane 3, Stone Rogers from the Jackets. Lane 4, Evan Carpenter from Berkeley. Lane 5, Cedric J. Rivera from the Jackets. And lane 6, Griffin Batchelor from the Berkeley Bears.
And it looks like lane 2, 3, and 4 are all pretty close so far, with lane 2 slightly ahead.
You can see Coach Justin Gray over there, first-year coach, as I've said before. Took over for Bill Swink and Pat Dodge a few years ago. Avondale has had anything but consistent head coaches for their male swim team, as well as their girls. Alrighty, quarter of the way through here, this 500-yard freestyle. Looks like Berkeley's in lane 4, followed closely by Stone Rogers from Avondale. Looks like lane 4, 3, and 2 are all pretty even right now. We'll see how that shapes up.
And here you can see them waving or pumping the markers. Waving it means keep going at that steady pace, while pumping it means pick up the pace. So as you can see in lane 5, I believe, that his partner was telling him to go faster.
Often the swimmers will talk to their counter, as they call them, before the race, letting them know what kind of split times they would like. So the counters will keep an eye on the clock and see, engage how the swimmer's pace is going. It's important to have a trustworthy counter so you know you can get the time you want. We still got lane 4. That's Evan Carpenter in first place, followed by Stone Rogers in third, and Matt Mancini in third. Yeah, Stone Rogers in second, Matt's in third. Pretty consistent race right now. So through 7 events, seems the Bears strong showing here, taking first places in several events, even sweeping one, I believe the 200 IM. Evan Carpenter, first place, consistent turns, and really turns in the 500 IM, or not the 500, the 500 freestyle, very important, as they are in several events, but the 500 mostly, just because there's so many of them. And if you're dropping time on your turns, you're dropping time, you know, 20 times.
Looks like Evan Carpenter is starting to build up a sizable lead. Looks like he's starting to pull away, and he's going to end up taking this race if he keeps up the pace.
Well, this just in, we have the score through 7 events. We have Berkeley Bears with a score of 65 to Avondale's 35. So, Bears are definitely came prepared into Avondale's pool and, you know, showing them up, really. So there you hear the bell indicating that it's the final lap for the swimmer in first place. There you see his teammate with the orange or red indicator, which means that it's his final lap as well. So Evan Carpenter with, looks like an easy win here. Not much. All right, Berkeley Bears, Evan Carpenter with the first place finish. Looks like Stone Rogers with the second place here. Nice swim by Stone.
Looks like coming up third, we've got Matt Mancini.
Berkeley Bears hold the two of the top 3 spots. Oh, Avondale takes one. Berkeley Bears continue to build their lead over Avondale in the meet itself. Alrighty. So we're finishing up here. Looks like 2 more swimmers.
We got lane six and, nope, we got lane five and lane one. Both from Avondale, we got John Odin and Cedric. Both on their final laps here. Cedric on his last length.
There's our final finisher for the 500-yard freestyle.
Good swim by all the boys. Yeah.
Great minds think alike.
All right, here we got event 9, the boys' 200-yard freestyle relay. And there will be 4 swimmers per lane, with each of them swimming a 50 free.
This is one of the more exciting events again. You know, the fastest you'll see with it being only a 50 freestyle. And off they go. We got Berkeley in lane 2, Jackets in lane 3, Berkeley again in lane 4, and Jackets in lane 5. For those at home, the center two lanes tend to be where the coaches put their fastest swimmers, so that's where you see the most competition. It looks like Avondale with the quick lead. That was a mill with a nice split there for the Jackets.
Looks like Kendall Cunnings is second for Avondale, and Berkeley's right behind. I believe that's Colin Tyker.
Already halfway here. Got Avondale still in the lead, followed by Berkeley. Avondale here with a nice lead over Berkeley. Going into the final swimmer. Here's the anchor. Here tends to be the fastest swimmer, or you know, the person that can really bring it home here. For Avondale, we have Kuhn Damani. And for the Bears, we have Evan Carpenter.
And it looks like Avondale's built up a sizable lead to take this one home.
Nice swim there by Kuhn Damani to bring it home for the Jackets.
I believe that's their first event that they've won.
I believe so as well. So the relay team of Emil, Kendall, Colin, and Kulin take the W on this one. Nice swim by those boys. Avondale's first win of the night in the 200-yard freestyle relay.
All right. Up next here we got the 100-yard backstroke.
Alrighty, here we go for the 100-yard backstroke. In lane 1 for the Jackets, we have Richard Fawaz. Lane 2, Stuart Craig for the Berkeley Bears. Lane 3, Andy Zhang for the Jackets. Lane 4, Cameron Burke for the Berkeley Bears. Justin Van Acker, lane 5 for the Jackets. And lane 6, Joseph Leverett for the Bears.
Looks like Berkeley's Cameron Burke is favored to win this one heavily with his time of a 108.
All right, as you see, the backstroke start is a little different than most starts. The swimmer starts in the water and springs himself backwards. I was a backstroker when I used to swim in high school, and I could tell you that gave me more problems than anything else really. There's a lot of repetition working on, you know, getting the right arc and getting out of the water at the right speed. But it does really pay off in the end. So looks like lane four is in first place right now. That's Cameron Burke for the Berkeley Bears. Another thing with this backstroke here is timing yourself to turn on the wall. Swimmers will know their stroke count, as they say, and so they know exactly how many strokes it takes to go the length of the pool, so they turn over at the right time, otherwise they hit their head. I've done that plenty of times. So it looks like Cameron Burke for the Berkeley Bears with the first place finish. Nice swim by Cameron.
Great swim by all the boys.
See, nice sportsmanship there by Cameron, or actually really all of them. It's a good thing about swimming is really, there's always good sportsmanship, you know. You don't see that much these days. There's Cameron there. All right, coming up, we have the 100-yard breaststroke. It's our 11th event. This is heat 1 of 1.
In lane one, we've got Keegan Outland for the Yellow Jackets. Lane two, we got Griffin Batchelor for Berkeley. We got, in lane three, we have Emil for the Yellow Jackets. Lane four, we have Colton Tyker for Berkeley. Lane five, we've got Colin Damani for the Yellow Jackets. And lane six, we've got Brendan Smith for Berkeley. And as you can see here, they're, for the turns, are slightly different than for all the other strokes. You're not allowed to take a butterfly kick off the wall. And instead, you're allowed a pull where you take both of your arms up when you're doing a streamline, and you pull down to get as much distance as possible before taking your first breaststroke kick.
Looks like Emil from the Yellow Jackets with a nice lead. Emil, only a freshman this year, so now he's going to be doing big things here for the Jackets.
Shooting for the state cut here, potentially. Hear the timers cheering them on.
It's always good to have nice timers to, you know, push you.
And it looks like Emil won that one pretty easily.
And it looks like lane four, followed by lane five. So Avondale, Berkeley, Avondale. Emil takes his win. Colton with second and Kuhn with third. Nice swim by those boys. Again, you see the nice sportsmanship there by Emil. Alrighty, going into the last event. Neil, you want to intro this one?
Alright, we got the final event, and that is the boys 400-yard freestyle relay. This is pretty much the same exact thing as a 200-yard freestyle relay, but instead of swimming 50, they'll be swimming 100 for each swimmer.
See the heavy breathing by all the swimmers. You get to this point of the meet.
Everyone's
running on fumes, yeah.
Putting in their last efforts for this final event right here.
So nice start there by Berkeley in lane four. Eli Folk seems to be in the lead. Already with a nice lead, Eli Folk has, you know, built the Bears up pretty nicely here. Going into his final turn.
Does look like lanes 1, 3, and 5 are slightly behind.
Alrighty, there goes the second swimmer for Berkeley. That's, let's see here, Joseph LeVarrett, sophomore.
Looks like lane three is right behind him. And lane three, we've got Colin Fultz. And it looks like they're starting to catch up.
So nice showing here by Colin Fultz to maybe pull Avondale back in this one. Still got a lot of ground to come up, overcome, but we'll see how it plays out.
Avondale's still down about a body length and a half, I'd like to say.
But gaining nonetheless, Colin Fultz with another, again with a strong, very strong swim here to close out the night.
That's the flip turns that get him.
All right, in for Berkeley Bears, we have Stuart Craig, as well as Andy Zhang for Avondale. So. Looks like Craig maybe built the lead up a little bit here. Andy Zhang doing the best he can to stay in the wake of Stewart.
And it looks like Berkeley's starting to pull away a little bit here as we approach the final summers for both teams.
So the anchors in the middle lanes for the two teams. We have Stone Rogers for Avondale and Caleb Duchamp for the Berkeley Bears. We'll see how it plays out. Both swimmers are getting ready to dive in here. And it looks like Andy Zhang is, caught up. Alrighty, here we go, final length. See if Stone and Caleb can give us a show here. It's like they're pretty neck and neck right now, Caleb and Stone.
And it looks like Caleb's actually starting to pull away here. But it's still actually fairly close, so.
Stone's doing his best to stay with Caleb. Nice turn there by Caleb. So it looks like Caleb, probably a body length on Stone. Let's see, going into the final length here, what these swimmers are made of. Oh, it's neck and neck right
neck
now.
Neck and neck
Stone
right now.
Caleb. You can hear the crowd going crazy. Here's the finish. Looks like Caleb with the win there. That's Berkeley.
Just pulls it off.
Yeah. Awesome swim by the boys. Gave us all a show. That's all I can ask for. Well, Berkeley in first place, Avondale in second, both eight relays. Looks like lane two. Berkeley should finish here in third, followed by, they're still going. So it looks like lane five then.
Looks like Richard Fawaz in lane five to finish it off.
There we go. There's your
Avondale grabbing third there.
If I had to guess, I'd say the Berkeley Bears came in here and took the W. Good swims by all their boys. Still, good job by Avondale, hanging with them the best they could. You know, they got a new coach, so the rebuilding process is definitely in full swing here. That is your final event of the night.
Looks like Berkeley will take this one home with a W. And we will be getting the final score shortly here once we get the results finalized. We'll be right back.
see the boys there drying off, going over to the huddle. No words of encouragement from Justin, but I'm sure he's gonna let them know that they're gonna have to pick it up. We're gonna get some more wins in the future. There's, see the Berkeley Bears definitely thrilled after a win in Avondale's pool. Justin Gray.
Telling them. It's only the first home meet. There's still several more meets to go before leagues.
There's Berkeley's farewell cheer. Most of the times the swimmers will give a, there's the traditional handshake between the teams. It's always nice to see that kind of sportsmanship. Again, swimming's not the most hostile sport, so no sportsmanship is pretty easy. Again, great showing by both teams. Now, roughly halfway through the season, come a long way, and still a long way to go. So. So the final score for the Berkeley Avondale meet, we have Berkeley coming out on top with a score of 110-66 Avondale. Pretty good win there for Berkeley. It's got to feel good. All right, this is CMN-TV here at Avondale Berkeley Swim Meet. Thanks again for watching. My name's Christian Nault.
And I'm Neil Damani.
Have a good night.